சகோதரி சகோதரன்மாரே, எல்லாருக்கும் என்டே நமஸ்காரம். குட் ஈவினிங் டு ஆல். ஐம் வெரி ஹாப்பி டு அட்ரஸ் யூ அட் தி வெலிடிக்டரி ஃபங்க்ஷன் ஆஃப் தி மாத்ருபூமி இன்டர்நேஷனல் ஃபெஸ்டிவல் ஆஃப் லெட்டர்ஸ், விச் ஹேஸ் எவால்வ்டு ஆஸ் த லார்ஜஸ்ட் லிட்டரரி ஃபெஸ்டிவல் இன் சவுத் இந்தியா. லெட் மீ அட் தி அவுட்செட் கங்க்ராச்சுலேட் the management of Mathrubhumi on their initiative in organizing this literary venture, which set the stage for the convergence of over 300 international and national writers, speakers and performers. This event has certainly enhanced Kerala's reputation as a land that responds positively to the literary and cultural movements of the world. Sir, though I was away from Trivandrum last 2 days because I was preoccupied with the Honorable Vice President at Kochi, on the inaugural day I noted everything. Today I was watching all your programs. Even I can point out this around 3:30 to 4, I had the opportunity to hear the interaction of three Jayarajans from Kannur. All three Jayarajans, very interested in the same dais, and good questions put to them. They answered, including the Sabarimala. I able to follow. That's why in the introduction, when they mentioned in Malayalam, I stood up and acknowledged. Till I enter into the car, I was watching this Mathrubhumi. It's a very dense, and everywhere you see, from the gate to this entire area, all youngsters are waiting or watching our programs. The credit goes to the Mathrubhumi. In Kerala, the role played by the print media in the social movements even before the 20th century is well known. The print medium had encouraged more people to become literate and even helped in giving a definite shape to the alphabets and quickened the standardization of our language. Among the newspapers that emerged in the last century, Mathrubhumi has earned a special place by encouraging the growth of Malayalam literature and by strengthening the struggle for independence. Therefore, Mathrubhumi's role in building the Kerala society that we see today is truly significant. I would see this International Festival of Letters as a continuation of the encouragement accorded by Mathrubhumi to the growth of Malayalam literature. Initially, it was through periodicals and books. Undoubtedly, majority of our writers of today would acknowledge the support and encouragement they received from this publishing house in their earlier days. Writers as well as readers have always regarded publication of a work in Mathrubhumi daily or weekly as a benchmark of quality in the literary sphere. Today, through this International Festival of Letters, Mathrubhumi has offered global exposure to Malayalam literature, its writers, their thoughts and ideas. I am happy that this year's International Festival of Letters was a celebration of letters as well as ideas which are of contemporary relevance. The discussions which involved vibrant intellectuals from all the 5 continents was also an encouragement for our aspiring writers and performers, that it gave our young writers and performers a unique opportunity to interact with the universal figures in their respective fields. It is truly laudable. one can definitely see this event as the greatest global exposure offered to our writers and artists. As a person who was observing the news about this event, I was impressed by the galaxy of noted writers and thinkers who enriched this festival through their presence. The presence of Ms. Germaine Greer, Australian-born writer and one of the most influential feminist and social critic, and Mr. Hassan Blasim of Iraq, who is considered the greatest living writer of Arab fiction, and many others, was certainly a new experience for Kerala. Like last year, the writers, noted journalists and artists from our country, like Dr. Shashi Tharoor, Member of Parliament, and Sri N. Ram, a world-renowned dancer, Srimati Padma Subramaniam, and many others have made their presence felt in this event. Stopping for a moment, our chairman, Mr. Virendra Kumar, maybe out of his anxiety, even informed me that next year I have to participate, and he might have come across, I have still 7 more months exactly. 4th September 2019, my term expires. If God gives me another chance to be here, definitely I will come and do my job. Interactions with the people of such high profile certainly inspires our young writers. At a time when serious doubts are raised about whether the habit of reading has suffered a setback in our society, this exposure to writers and literatures of various nations can also help in the widening of the influence of Malayalam literature. We also must ensure better global exposure to our works through translations into other languages of the world. As this event has been held by a newspaper group, I feel that a word or two about the present-day journalism will not be out of place. Every responsible medium has to give priority to information that is useful to our citizens. The media can set the agenda and suggest what to think, but certainly cannot insist on how to think, for it is the reader's freedom. Sensationalism may help to sell a publication, which is nowadays called a product to be sold. But the motto for journalism should never be, I sensationalize, therefore I sell. Because every medium has to be not just a message, but a social message. I say this because going after sensational news brings very little benefit to our people. I feel the state's efforts for rebuilding itself would succeed only if we ensure adequate space and importance for development and social issues. Newspapers like Mathrubhumi, which have been highlighting our new building dreams, could easily set a trend in such matters, since it has already achieved success in promoting literature and agriculture. I greet all the writers, speakers and performers who have attended this festival of letters and wish them all the best. The festival directors, Sri P.V. Rajiv and Sri Sabin Iqbal, also deserve appreciation for their service as curators of this festival. I also compliment the organizers for conducting this function, this festival and this function in a befitting manner. Ellavarkum ende aasamsagal nanni jai.